I have just been handed an item reporting by the Washington Post tonight saying the Deputy Attorney General, Rod Rosenstein, threatened to resign after the narrative emerging from the White House last night cast him as a prime mover of the decision to fire Comey, and that the president acted only on his recommendation. This is sourced, again, anonymity, a source close to the White House. So this would indicate that Rosenstein's name and weight was behind that three-page amalgam, the argument against Comey, but that he resented it being compiled as his argument for firing.
Right. You would think that, you know, when you're asked to put something like that together by the president, you would expect to, that the person would understand that this is probably going to be used as a pretext to fire the FBI director. He never said explicitly that he made that recommendation in that letter. And I think if that reporting is correct, then that's a sign that the deputy attorney general has bristled and gotten upset at the White House's attempt to spin this at what Vice President Pence said today, basically saying that, well, this was all just the response to this memo, sort of taking agency away from the president in this way because they think it insulates him from the critique. It seems rather obvious that he fired Comey because he was upset at the Russia investigation that he continued to push. And so it was sort of an alibi, but in sort of providing an alibi for the president, it would seem that they alienated the deputy attorney general here. But as Steve said, there is just nobody in this White House capable of standing up to the president and pushing back on this right now. We were trying to figure out exactly who was, you know, in the real inner circle when this was happening today. Chairman, the Chief of Staff, Reince Priebus, Steve Bannon, they were sort of in the second tier. They found out about this, were a little bit cautious, cautioned the president a little bit about, you know, are you sure you want to do this? You're going to get some blowback. The optics may not be great. But as one White House source told me earlier, those two these days are not pushing back very hard on anything because they don't have the standing with the president. And this is a very thin-skinned president at this point who does not want to take flack from anybody and wants to make sure and feel that everybody in that White House working for him is on his team and going to defend him 100%.
Steve Schmidt, last word, 30-second reaction to this Washington Post development. This is the FBI director is a direct report to the deputy AG who was held out as the authority, as the mover behind the firing.
Once again, this White House is mainstreamed lying to a degree which just beggars the imagination. You think about this over the last 24 hours. Sean Spicer has lied. The vice president has lied. Ms. Sanders has lied. Across the board, every person who walks out of that White House, stands in the briefing room on the North Lawn, and talks about this has lied to the American people. And it's the type of lie that requires the liars to believe the people they're lying to are stupid, because this is just plain as day what this is about. And the claims that it's about anything else other than the Russia investigation are just completely ludicrous on their face.